be in her stomach, she love it when I slide it. I don't know what love is, but baby, we can try it. Treat these bitches like they got corona.
Okay. Oh,
let me
adjust that a bit. Okay. Hi guys, this is me, Tyler Miraja. I just woke up. I'm gonna kind of give you guys a few, how would I word this? A few minutes of my morning, or my morning routine, whatever.
This is how I wake up. I put my sheets in the,
let me not do the ankle. I put my sheets in the washer, so now I just have no sheets. And then I wash the one pillowcase that I do use. Out of all my pillowcases, it's my safe one. And yeah, I just wanted to show y'all this beauty. Like, this is me when I wake up. I haven't even brushed my teeth yet, washed my face, nothing. I just literally rinse my mouth out with water. That's it. And this is how I look. Like, I don't know, I'm just such a beautiful person. I just need to capture this on video.
Y'all hear me? Y'all hear me? Y'all can't? Oh, well, this is loud as I'm gonna talk. This is my morning voice. I put your bitch like my lady. Shawty been back like the mage. Place with her dope like the age. I'm in the kitchen.
Put old niggas, but they betray you. Really, they are some bitches. with your cards and win a game or two. I hit you with a depot, I just smoked a plane or two. I just landed on Mars and I don't know what to do.
I might black out. Shawty wanna show her ass out. All black red got a good shot. Pouring up lean top pass out. I got a whole lot of mud shots. Too much money can't count the squat. Back seat with a bad shot. Rick Owens with a tag shot. Got a bad beat with an ass shot. 220 get a good shot.
Turn me up.
Hi guys, it's Kyla Marshall. And welcome to my YouTube channel. If you don't know me already, my name is Kylie Walker, that's pretty much it. I know that I'm not a model, but give me some names, I do, whatever. But, you know, my name is Kylie Walker, and it's kind of basic. I'm not doing anything in my life right now.
I've been told the world, get your fucking roll on. Herb, I thought you was gonna lend it to me. Hold on. Girl, it's sundress season, get your stroll on. Waving at your cousin, man, that you told on. Well, I always gotta see you with your clothes on. Ain't gonna tell nobody nothing, get your hold on.
Oh, did y'all watch the Lakers versus the Nuggets last night? Bro. That's it. Like, anybody that's saying the Nuggets are gonna win the championship, they're dumb. They're really dumb. Like, I'm not a Lakers fan. I'm not a fan of any team. I just love Giannis Antetokounmpo, but that's it. So, all I wanted to say was, like, just, like, anybody that's really betting on the Nuggets over the Lakers, dumb. They're dumb. Like, everything's Kobe. That's period. Like, come on now. Use your common sense. Like, R. Kelly said, I think it was him.
Use your common sense.
I haven't really been watching basketball like that, like I've used to. Whatever, this is pretty much the end of my YouTube video. I was gonna show y'all, like, well, I could still show y'all, whatever. So, first, what you wanna do is you want to get your materials that you use to brush your teeth, and this is what I use to brush my teeth. I have my toothbrush that I use for my teeth, the toothbrush I use for my tongue, my Colgate, or yeah, is this, no, this is not Colgate because I don't use Colgate. Wait, is it Colgate? Girl, I don't know, but I don't use that gel toothpaste, that's just disgusting. I have my toothpaste, it's white. Then I have my floss because you need to floss your teeth twice a day. Like, what are you talking about?
It's your favorite outfit, they gon' know about it. It's your favorite outfit, they gon' know about it. That's a real one in your reflection. And that's a blessing, one you ain't got a question. Still got some real niggas with me, not to mention. Baby mama, mama quit.
Bitch, I'm rich, I'm tryna fuck on air thigh. Bitch, I'm rich, I'm tryna beat your neck guy. Savage got the problem with the red dot.
First thing you do is floss.
Yeah, nigga, I ain't never spent $1 jar. Paper, rock, cheese, what I swear that nigga, I'll tell. All my niggas real fans, all on my cup. 21 Savage, I be hanging with a check be. I don't want to piss a little bitch, just neck me. Bitch, you tryna screenshot a nigga, don't text me.
Teeth is all brushed. Then we're gonna brush our tongue, okay? Now some people, they use a tongue scraper. I don't like that. No, I don't like that. So I just use another toothbrush, a separate toothbrush, and I brush my tongue. Simple, period, just like that. Okay. Okay. Brush off. A nice clean tongue. And see. Then after that, you pretty much rinse everything off. Clean the toothbrushes, whatever.
Keep it real, it's a lot of fake love. Niggas hate, but they bitches in love. Paint the Bentley, I white like a dove. I took off, ain't the same as it was. Keep it out, I walk to the bus. I was up, I can tell when it cut. Can't tell me that she had a slut.
Say hi, Tyler. Hi, Tyler. Okay. Yeah, some days I just wake up and I make breakfast first. And then other days I take a shower and then eat breakfast and stuff like that. Then my third thing to do after brushing my teeth is drink water. I love to drink water. That's the only thing I drink. I don't really juice anything like that. So I just drink water. That's my third thing to do after brushing my teeth because I don't know. It just makes me feel like I'm cleansing my mouth out after doing all that hard scrubbing, you know, stuff. So yeah. Boy, get ready for this treatment. But first I gotta make them beg for it, cause I treat these niggas like play toys. I might grind on them like a skateboard, then make them buzz hard like an AR. Yeah, I heard he had a BBC, and if he had Puerto Rican, tell him when I keep. And if the head whack, I'm a duck, I'm a fat person, on point, he ain't gotta look for me, cause I'm a key step. You may have heard that before. If you haven't, that pretty much means that I'm skinny on the outside, but on the inside, it's like all my organs and everything are like for a fat person. Like, for example, you know, when you see skinny people, you may think that they're really athletic or they have a high tolerance and endurance for a lot of things. Whereas some of us, or let me just speak for myself, whereas for me, it's the opposite. Like, I have a high endurance. However, I get out of breath really easily. I get shortness of breath easily. Like, I can walk up like maybe 5 stairs and after that I'm out of breath, you know? I can do something that really challenges my lungs and everything and I'll be out of breath. Like, it's from anything, from just walking. Like, I don't know, I love to walk. I absolutely love. I love to walk. Like, I love to walk. I don't know how to explain that. I don't even know how that came up to me. But I love to walk. However, walking up some stairs, walking down some stairs, it will make me out of breath, quick as hell. So, it's just really weird. But, that's okay. And yeah, so I may cook breakfast right now. I may not. It just all pretty much depends on how I'm feeling. Like, if I'm feeling like I want to eat breakfast before I get in the shower, because I have, I self-diagnosed myself with low blood sugar. So if I don't eat before I take a shower or do something that's going to consume a lot of my energy and time, then I'm going to be out of breath. I'm going to have how would I put this? Like, you know, like when you stand up, for people with low iron, when you stand up really fast and everything's just black, if I don't eat before I do something that's gonna consume a lot of my energy, it will be like that. Like, I'll start getting hot, I'll be out of breath, and then like I'll be really like not tired, but I'll be in the state where like my body will be ready to give up on me. So I'll have to squat or just stay still for like a few moments until like I get like, I guess, all my energy back into one spot in my body. I don't know. But yeah. So I try to eat sometimes before I take a shower, because when I take a shower, it consumes a lot of my energy, because I do a lot of things in the shower. I do a lot of scrubbing. I mean, not like I'm dirty or anything, but I just like to do a lot of scrubbing. I may want to shave. Like, it just depends on how I'm feeling. And I don't know, for some reason, maybe the water, like the water probably just consumes a lot of my energy because it's hitting me. I don't know if that makes any sense. Don't listen to me. I'm not the smartest person you know, but I'm not stupid. But anyways, yeah, so I self-diagnosed myself with low blood sugar because I remember in middle school one day, I guess I didn't eat. And so like my body started, like it felt like I was sweating, but I wasn't sweating. My body started doing that. And then like my eyes were just blacking out. And then like I couldn't like really stand up because I had to eat. So that's what, when I looked that up like maybe a few years ago, that's what it showed, that I had low blood sugar. But low blood sugar is when you're diabetic. And I've went to have my blood drawn and everything maybe like 6 years ago. They told me I wasn't diabetic and I didn't have low blood sugar. But till this day, I still feel like there's something like not fair. And it may be because I'm vegan. It's definitely not because I'm vegan, because I don't get my sufficient protein amount I should be getting every day as a vegan. That has nothing to do with it, because this has been happening before I even went vegan. Like, so I don't know if I'm just not eating enough or what, but I love to eat food. I'm not one of those, I forgot the word for it, but I'm not one of those people that just starves themselves. Like, when I'm not hungry, I'm just not hungry. That's it. Like, there's nothing I'm not gonna force myself to eat. That's the thing about me. Like, I don't force myself to do too much of anything. Like, when people are constantly using the bathroom because they drink a lot of water, that's not me. I'm gonna drink as much water as my body tells me that it wants. I'm not gonna overdo it. I'm not gonna overdo it. So people are just like, when they see me, they're like, how come you never really have to use the bathroom? First of all, I don't like using public restrooms. Let's start there. Secondly, I don't overdrink water to the point where you have to constantly go to the bathroom. I don't do that. I drink as much water as my body tells me it needs to have. So whenever I say I'm thirsty, whenever my mind tells my brain that I'm thirsty, or whenever my, what is it? Whenever my brain just tells my body that I'm thirsty, that we're thirsty, or whenever my body tells my brain that we're thirsty, then we're gonna drink some water. But I'm not gonna not be thirsty and drink water. Like, that's some of y'all problem. That's probably why y'all use the bathroom too much. Like, I understand that society says that you need to drink so much water a day, but it's like, come on, sweetie, I'm not dehydrated. I'm gonna drink as much water as I need to, and that's gonna be that. You know, I'm not striving for clear pee. I'm not striving for that. If it helps you sleep at night, then go ahead and strive for that. But it doesn't help me sleep at night. Okay? Nothing is wrong with me. My body is fine. So me over-drinking water, drinking more water than I need to, it's not helping me sleep at night. It doesn't do anything for me. You know what I mean? So people may think it does stuff for you, but I wouldn't think so. Because if you drink enough water that you need to be drinking, you should be fine. You don't need to over-drink water. Have y'all seen this TikTok thing where it's just like, you're dehydrated if like your the skin on your finger stays up? Well, let me show y'all, because I've been doing this trick. I don't know if it's real, but I do it. I does it, and my skin never stays up. So I just kind of go like that. Oh, y'all can't even see. So you see how it's flat? You see how it's flat like this? You gotta squeeze it, and if it stays up, then that means you're dehydrated. Oh, y'all didn't even see. Bro, just wasting my time. So take your finger, the little wrinkly part. You see how it's flat, right? Flat. Then you squeeze it. If you squeeze it and the skin stays up, that means you're dehydrated. You know what I mean? It just means that you're dehydrated. I don't know if it's real, but whenever I do it, my skin doesn't stay up. You know what I mean? It does not stay up. But yeah. That's pretty much it. This skin is so weird. Like, why is it so wrinkly? I don't know. Okay. So, yeah. Anyways, before my thing was cut off, I think that's pretty much it for my vlog today. What I have for breakfast every morning, I have pancakes and potatoes. You know, like russet potatoes or either hashed potatoes. I have either of those because potatoes is my favorite food. And yeah, so that's it. I don't really have much planned today besides going to get my lash fill. You know, I could use it. And that's it. So yeah. I hope you guys enjoy my vlogs or whatever. It's not really a vlog, it's just me really being conceited and self-centered, I guess. That's what I see when I think of it or when I see myself. I think that I'm very conceited and self-centered at times. Not all the time. Sometimes, 50% of the time, I will say that I do think that I'm ugly, and that's probably because of the people I let in my life, how I allow them to treat me, affect my mind, and how I view myself. But yeah, just don't let people come into your life and treat you however they want to treat you. Set boundaries. You know, if somebody's not treating you right, or they're making you feel bad about yourself, and they're making you relook or rethink yourself in the mirror, you need to cut them off. Like, I'm saying this to you, but I'm also saying this for me, to me and this camera. So, just set boundaries. Cut people off if they're not treating you right. And that's that. You know? Fuck them. We ball. Period. But, yeah. I admire my beauty so much. Like, it's just like, how can one be so freaking gorgeous? Like, maybe it's the lighting, but I don't know. Like, it's just like, I don't know, guys, but love yourself. You know, you may not look like me. You may look uglier than me. You may look better than me. Love yourself, okay? Don't be pretty like them. Don't be beautiful like them. Be beautiful like you, okay? So let me say this again because I messed up a little bit. Don't be beautiful like them. Be beautiful like you, okay? Don't go by what society and Instagram and Twitter is telling you are beauty standards. You're beautiful. You need to see that for yourself, okay? You need to see that for yourself. You don't need to do this or do that. You don't need to get your nose pierced. You don't need to do any of this. Have makeup on, you know, wear eyelashes, get lip fillers, get a nose induction or whatever you want to call it. A nose, a Botox thing, whatever. You don't need to do any of that to be beautiful. God made you. God, the universe, spirit guides, ancestors, they made you the way you are for a reason, okay? And that's for you to love yourself. You need to love yourself. You need to love your body because you may have some characteristics about yourself that other people wish they had or they don't have. You know what I mean? And it's very special about us, and it makes you very special. Okay, those certain characteristics that you have that other people may not have, it probably makes you very special. It does make you special. So just love it. Love yourself. Don't be beautiful like them. Be beautiful like yourself. You know what I mean? Don't go by Instagram and Twitter's beauty standards. It's fake, I promise you. Instagram models, they go through things too. They're not always looking that good, or they're probably using Facetune or some Photoshop app, whatever, just to appear good on the media. And I think that's where a lot of us go wrong, especially including myself. You know, we look at beauty standards portrayed on Instagram and social media, whatever. And we go from there and think that that's how I need to look. And I think that's my problem, you know what I mean? I think that's why I suffer and deal with insecurities within myself. And I rethink and relook at myself in the mirror and think that maybe I'm missing something. You know, I don't have that. My eyes don't do this thing that her eyes does. My lips aren't as big as hers. So I think that makes me ugly. You know, I look in the mirror and I look at myself and I tell myself that, just based off of what Instagram and social media portrays. And that's not healthy, it's not good. So if you need to, just delete your Instagram. delete your social media. If it gives you a peace of mind, do it. If it doesn't bring you peace, if it's not your muse, if it's not making you calm at night, get rid of it. Stop thinking about it, you know? Block it out of your life, because at the end of the day, you want to be happy. You need to be happy. If you're not happy, you're just going to be miserable. And a miserable hoe ain't a happy hoe. And a happy hoe ain't a hating hoe. You know what I mean? So, yeah. Love yourself. One day I'm going to cut my hair. Well, one day soon. Let me say that. One day soon, I'm going to cut my hair bald like Amber Rose, just because I want to try it out. You know, the one thing I love about myself is that I'm not afraid to do anything. Like, I will wake up one day, and if I want to do something, my mind is made up about it, I'll do it. I'll do it. And that's one thing I absolutely love about myself. That's how I became vegan. I just woke up one day and I said, fuck it, let's just do it. And I haven't went back since. So that's one of my favorite aspects about myself. When something is in my mind and it's made up and my mind is like, we need to do this, I'll do it. One thing about me is I'm not a liar. I'm gonna follow through with everything that I do, because I know how it feels for somebody to lie to you and not follow through with everything that they're telling you. You know what I mean? So that's one thing I can say about myself. I'm not a lying. I'm not a lying ass bitch. So yeah. Okay, so I'm done being self-centered, I guess. Whatever. Bye guys. And thank you so much for watching my channel. You are appreciated. You are beautiful. You need to love yourself. Don't trust him. Don't trust that bitch. Don't trust her. Don't love these hoes. Fuck these hoes. Focus on yourself, okay? And at the end of the day, when you go lay in your bed, if you have a bed to lay in, if you don't, that's okay. That's okay. Work towards getting a bed to lay in. At the end of the day, when you go to sleep at night, just remember, whatever is bothering you, you need to let it go, and you need to be happy. Because if you're not happy, then your skin is going to break out and you're going to have acne. You know what I mean? And you don't want that. You don't want that. But it's okay to have acne, though. You can still be beautiful and have acne. You can still, I'm beautiful, right? And my skin is not the clearest, but I'm still beautiful. I'm still beautiful. And it's okay. But still, when you sleep at night, just let it go. Just remember, you need to let it go. You need to stop. You don't get paid. Think about it. Do you get paid to sit there and lay down and go to sleep and concern yourself with how others treat you and how you allow disrupt your peace and your happiness? Let that shit go, straight up. That's all I'm gonna say. So yeah, have a great day, everybody. Happy Saturday. Be blessed. And by the way, I can't wait until Christmas time. Bye.